You probably want to install lights in your camper van for obvious reasons, and that is exactly what we're going to cover today in lesson number 2 of this branch circuit playlist. My name is Nate, and welcome to the Explorist Life Mobile, Marine, and Off-Grid Electrical Academy. Now, before we get started, there's a couple prerequisite pieces of information you need to know, like cutting wire, stripping wire, crimping terminals into wire, but we've already covered that in a specific playlist of this academy, so go back and review that if you don't already know how to do this part. And lastly, before we get started, the fuse block that we're using in this particular demo is the Blue Sea blade fuse block. Now, there's several different types of fuse blocks on the market, like the Progressive Dynamics fuse block, the Blue Sea Safety Hub, the Tiger Expedition UFO 200, and all of those are realistically going to be connected in much the same way. They're all getting their power from a different distribution hub, like the Victron Lynx distributor, which is getting its power from the battery. But we're going to skip all of that side of the system and focus mainly on how we get power to the rest of the branch circuit. Let's get started. So we're going to start over here on this side with our fuse block. I've already got the fuse pulled out of the fuse block, so there's no power coming to these wires. And we're going to start with the switch. So a real quick rundown of how switches work is these two pins on the back of the switch are simply connected or disconnected from each other depending on which direction the switch is. So connected, disconnected, connected, disconnected, so on and so forth. So basically all that does is it allows the two wires to be coming in contact with these two wires. So if you can imagine if these were connected here and then these were connected here, and it's connected, disconnected. And that's exactly what the switch is doing, just connecting and disconnecting. So, to install our switch, I've already got a spade terminal on this end that I'm going to put right here in the middle terminal of the switch. Push it into place. And then coming off of the switch is going to be another wire with another spade terminal. It's been crimped in place. Coming out to our light location. Now at the switch with the negative wire, personally, I like to put a lever nut on the negative wire. So I'm going to lift those up, push the wire in, and then snap that back down into place. And then this just gives us a lot of flexibility for this switch in the event that we need to make negative wires go elsewhere for other lights and circuits. It just gives us some flexibility, but this could just go right through if that's what you like. For the wire going to our light, one side is just going to go into the lever nut. And then our switch location wiring is all finished. So now we can move to where we're going to be wiring the light. Got our puck light here. On the back of that, it says positive and negative. So black is positive and white is negative. And that's kind of confusing because on a standard DC circuit, black is negative. So just pay really special attention whenever you're connecting wires that are different colors like that. Lever nut onto the positive wire. Lever nut onto the negative wire. Black positive wire to the red lever nut. And white negative wire to the lever nut for the negative wire. Double check all our connections, positive to positives, negative to negatives, and black positive here to red positive here, and white negative here on the back of the light to negative wire here. And put our fuse back in place. Turn on our switch. Oh, it was already on. So, works just as expected. Okay, what if we wanted to add an additional light? I'll show you how to do that. Go ahead and pull my fuse so we're not working with a live circuit. And then, if we were doing a light in the same location, Well, on this lever nut here, we've got three spots on each one, so we're just going to add another light to it, just the same as we did the first one. So we can take our white wire from our next light, put it into the lever nut, like so. Same thing with the positive wire, just like that. All positives together, all negatives together, just like that. Two wires in one location. Fuse back in place and switch. Both lights working? Yep. So it's as simple as that. Now, I think a lot of people typically want to space lights apart a little bit. Sometimes it's nice to have these two together and then, you know, 3 or 4 or 5 feet back, I have another pair of lights, and here's how you would do that. We're going to turn our switch off, pull our fuse, pull one of our lights out of this one. And then instead of the next light, we're just going to put some extension wires on here. And these can be sort of as long as you need them to, you know, 5 feet or whatever, to get you back to the next light. Oops. Talking and not paying attention to what I'm doing. All negative wires together. All positive wires together. Just like so. And like I said, these wires could be the ones that are 5 feet long or whatever, going back to your next section of lights. More lever nuts. Black positive wire for the lights, remember. And white negative wire for this light. Okay, and that is all connected. So remember, these could be, this wire here between these lights could be pretty long, could be 5 feet, could be 10 feet, doesn't really matter for the most part. Just for the tabletop demo, that's what we're using to get these two lights to different locations. Put our fuse back in place, hit our light switch, and we're good to go. And this is pretty much how this would end up looking, you know, as it was installed. Your switch is going to be in one location, you know, above a door or something accessible like that. And then these wires here are going to be pretty long and run to where the first light is going to be, where all of this is. And then these lights here, or these wires here, could be kind of long again, going to the next light. Now, if you wanted to put 2, 3, 4 lights in one location, they do make lever nuts that have multiple different sizes. So this one in particular has 5 different ports here where we could put power coming into them, and then we could put 4 lights coming off of this. The key takeaway here is that all positives need to be together and all negatives need to be together for each light or each group of lights. And that's really how easy it is to wire just one circuit of lights. It's super simple. The problem with this is you only have one switching area. So if you wanted to switch at the front and a switch at the back, you can't do that with this setup. But in the next video, I'm going to show you how to do it. And unfortunately, it gets pretty complicated. So when you're designing your system, consider just having one switch location. It's going to make your life significantly easier, especially if it's just an 80 square foot van that you're in. Just have one switch location. So that's how easy it is. In the next video, we'll be covering 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10 way switching. So we'll see you over there.